Solvete Omnes. Today we're looking at Book 4, lines 9 through 29. It's a big chunk, but you can, if you want specific, if I'm going through specific lines, you can just fast forward and you can look at it. This is the speech that Dido gives at the beginning of Book 4, where she is falling in, she has fallen in love with Aeneas, and she's talking to her sister here, and she's torn on what to do and trying to not fall, trying to talk herself in, and then she's trying to talk herself out of this love. So it's a great speech, very famous. Anna soror quae me suspensum insomnia terret. So, Sister Anna, vocative, quae insomnia nominative, what what dreams terrify me agitated. Okay, me agitated. Me is suspensum there. Is accusative. Alright. Quis novis hic nostri succesit sequus hospes, quam sese oeferens, quam forte pectore et armis. Quis novis. Now we start off with all these nice nominatives. Quis, novus, they're all going together. Hic, nostri sequus, that is a dative, going with succesit. And then hospes is another nominative. So we can say, quis, what new guest, I don't even want to translate heck, but you can say like this, I guess. What new guest has come to our regents? It's like, and sometimes editors want to put like a relative clause in here. You could do that as well, you know, to make it a little bit better. Okay. And then quem sese ora ferens. Now, if you look in the book, you'll see the notes there say, like, how noble an appearance. It is kind of a really awkward thing in English to deal with. Of course, ferens is a PAP in the nominative. So, like, bearing himself in respect to which, respect to his in his face, like, whom or something, himself, like, you can see the grammar there. You can say how noble in appearance. And then quam here is how with a forte pectore, with a brave heart and armies and arms. And this is actually from arms, like, but this a brave guy. You know, he's traveled all around the Mediterranean. Credo equidem nec vana fides genus esse deorum. I like to kind of, with this one, I like to kind of put this in parentheses. It's kind of, she's just kind of saying this on her own. Credo, of course, is your verb. I believe indeed, nor is my faith in vain, that, an indirect statement, genus here, genus, esse, infinitive, deorum, that his race is of the gods. Okay, so I believe indeed, nor is my fidelity in vain, that his race is of the gods. All right. And then we go on. She says, Degeneres animos timor anguit, heu quibus ille jactatis fatis quae bella exhausta canebat. Now, I like this next sentence. This is a good little kind of like, you know, a wise saying here. So, degeneres animos is your nice, is accusative. Timor is your subject, is a verb here. So, fear proves degenerate spirits or degenerate mind or base or shameful mind, you could say. So, the cool thing I like about this is that, you know, saying that fear prove, like, will show the true character of this. And she's talked with Aeneas by this point and seen how he, you know, all the brave things he's done, going through Troy, the travels he's done. Alas, quibus ille, nice ablative, nominative, jactatis, there's an ellipsis of est here, fatis, ablative going with quibus. So, alas, that by what fates was that man, jactatis, tossed, buffeted. You know, she's just saying, wow, he's really gone through a lot. Quae bella exhausta. Those are all objects, PPP, of course. What exhausted wars he sung about. you know, he told his story. Okay, it's like, wow, he's just done through, he's gone through everything. You know, she really likes him. I mean, the story of book two and book three are really gripping. And if, you know, he came in there, told the story, and she is smitten with him. All right, now we're getting to the tough sentence here. This is a real tough one, and it kind of goes on for a bit. And she's using these nice conditionals here, and it is a little tricky. So, si mihi, if for mihi non animo fixtum in motum quae sederet, ne cui me vinculo velum sociare jungale postquam primus amore deceptum morte fulfillit. All right. So, sed mihi, but to me, dative, non animo, nice ablative, fixtum et emotum. Now, these are PPPs, and I would translate, and these are, I'd say these are nominative describing it, okay? Both of them. And then ceteret is imperfect subjunctive, and this is going to be a present contrary to fact. It's going crazy. Now, the question, of course, is what's the subject of ceteret? The subject of ceteret is all this right here. Ne cui me vinculo velum sociare jungale. Okay, which is really crazy. Now, if we'll kind of keep figuring out the cases here while we have a chance here. Cui is of course from ali cui, because it's after ne and the ali has dropped out. Me, that should be accusative there. Okay, vinculo, nice ablative. Velum, in going with the ne clause, imperfect subjunctive. Sociare, nice infinitive. And then jungale is an adjective going with vinculo. Look at the I there. It's third declension adjective. It's ending in I. So it's going right there with the ablative. So, if for me, and we can go ahead and put it in here just to represent this whole clause here. If it were not sitting fixed and unmoved in my mind. And what's sitting fixed and unmoved in her mind? This whole thought here. So if for me it was not sitting fixed and unmoved in my mind, that I would not wish to join myself, accusative, to anyone, oh, to join, where's the join? Sociare. Okay? I would not wish to join myself to anyone in jungale, it's like marital, I mean, literally means the yoking, but in marital chains. So if it did not sit fixed and unmoved in my mind, that I would not wish to join myself in marriage chains to anyone after my first love, okay, deceived, and we have an ellipsis of me, deceived me, deceived by death. So if it not, and then she keeps going here. She keeps on giving these conditions here, and then si non paratissum, we'll keep going. But let's just stop right there, and I'll move it up so we can keep building. Now, we look here at this next one. Si non paratissum thalami taedaeque fuisset quic una forsam potui succumbere culpant. So she says, if this is not remaining fixed to my mind, and then she goes back to if. And then paratissum, you need to look in the book. It's going with fuisset, okay? And, like, it means it's impersonal, meaning the subject is it. So literally, like, it wearies me. Okay? But we can go ahead and make it active. Say, if not partisum thuisset, if I, and the worst thing, it takes an accusative and a genitive of what you're weary of. The genitive here, so this is genitive. So if I had not been, if I had not been weary of the bridal chamber and the bridal torch, so if I not been weary of getting married again. Wic. And the question of what's Wic going to? It's a great word. It's going with coal pie. Una is going with coal pie, and it tells you that this is dative. They're all dative. For some is perhaps. Perhaps potui. I could succumbere. Literally lie down to, but this is to succumb. I could succumb to this one fault. So if I was, you know, I'm not getting married again, she's saying, but if I were getting married, maybe I would get married to Aeneas. All right? She keeps on talking about her past here. Ana fatebor enem miseri post fata psychai. Conjugus et sparsos fraternicinam panate solus hinc inflexit sensus animaque labentum impulit. Anna, for I will confess, after the fates of my of miserable Psycheus, my spouse, and after the sprinkled, after the panates sprinkled with fraternal blood, this is referring back to her husband being killed by her brother, of course. Solus hic, this man alone, inflex, bends my senses and drives, strikes my slipping, my PAP, mine. And then she goes on and says, agnosco, I recognize the steps or the remains or the traces of my of the old flame, love. All right. And it goes on here, but for me, and she, and this is like a potential, I would wish, it's a weird subjunctive, I would wish first, and then oot's been left out, that the lowest earth, that's your subject here of De Hisket, would open up, or that I would wish that the Father, all-powerful, would drive me to the shades, to the underworld, with the lightning bolt. Okay? And then it keeps describing the underworld, the pale shades in Erebus and the profound night. Everything here is accused except Erebus, which is ablative. And then she says, I wish this would all happen before. And we have here, before, oh shame, okay, oh shame, I violo you, I violate you, and I loosen your laws. The shame of, like, not getting married again. Okay? So she wants to, the gods send her down to the underworld before she breaks her old vows to her old husband. That man, i.e. her husband, Meos Amores, Meos and Amores are going together. That man who joined me first to himself has taken away my love. Abstulit. Okay? That, and then she has a nice lullative, let that man have and preserve the love with himself in the tomb. All right, that's a long one. Volete omnes, lingua latina es vita. I will talk to you later. If you have questions, email me.